The final component of the net operating working capital calculation is accounts payable. Manoa buys aluminum coil from suppliers to manufacture the cans. Suppliers give Manoa credit on these purchases, which gives rise to accounts payable. As this discussion makes clear, it seems like a good idea to normalize accounts payable by purchases. We do not have information on historical purchases, but we can compute them from the information we have. The relation we are going to use is the evolution of inventories. As this formula indicates, the final inventory in a period is the inventory at the beginning of the period plus all the inventory added, we are going to approximate this as purchases, minus all the inventory sold. Let's compute purchases for 2016. The final inventory comes directly from the 2016 balance sheet. The initial inventory in 2016 is its inventory as of early morning in January 1st of 2016. This is the same as the inventory as of December 31st of 2015, so we take it from the 2015 balance sheet. COGS are in the 2016 income statement. Now, we can use the equation for the evolution of inventory to solve for purchases. Using the same process, we compute purchases in 2017. Now that we have purchases for 2016 and 17, we can compute the financial ratio called accounts payable days on hand. This is defined as accounts payables over daily purchases. We obtain 21 and 19 for 2016 and 2017 respectively. Since this ratio is relatively constant over time, we will use its average of 20 as our estimate of accounts payable days on hand in 2018. Now, we can estimate accounts payable in 2018 by multiplying accounts payable days on hand of 20 by daily purchases. The problem is that we do not have daily purchases in 2018. Should we also try to estimate it? It might appear we need to do this, but in fact, we have estimated so many items of the 2018 financials that we have already pinned down purchases. Recall the equation for the evolution of inventories and apply it to 2018. We know the final level of inventories in 2018. We estimated it before. We also know its initial level. It is the inventory as of the end of 2017. We obtained this number from the 2017 balance sheet. Also, we estimated COGS for 2018 when we were computing the net operating profit. Therefore, we can use this equation to solve for the level of purchases that our assumptions imply. Finally, using this level of purchases to compute daily purchases and multiplying by accounts payable days on hand of 20 leads to our forecast of accounts payable for 2018. The point I would like to make here is that we estimate many items, but we should make sure that our estimates are internally consistent. In our example, once we have inventories and COGS, we have in fact purchases.